Hello students, today I have come up with the part 8 of coordination compounds chapter. So in this part we will come up to the outer orbital complexes. Okay, so let's start with it. Okay, the first complex, I'm not telling which is outer orbital, which is inner orbital like that. I will directly explain with the hybridization. The first complex which I'll come up with is cobalt amine complex. This is the first complex. Okay, look at the position of ammonia. Look at the position of ammonia in the spectrochemical series. Means ammonia is moderate field ligand, neither too weak nor too strong. But you see the position of ammonia, ammonia is bit towards the stronger field ligand side. You can see the position of ammonia, it is bit towards the stronger field ligand side. The complexes of ammonia are not always strong field, means are not always spin paired complexes. But sometimes it can be spin paired also, and sometimes it cannot be spin paired also. It depends on the other factors for formation of complexes. Okay, in this complex, ammonia will be a strong field ligand. So cobalt is 4s2 3d7. If you find out the oxidation state of cobalt, it will be 3 plus in this complex. You have to write exactly the way I am writing it, okay? You can understand that these things cannot be done in MS Word. That's why I am showing you everything on board. Okay, if I fill up the electrons. Plus means 2 electrons up from the 4s and 1 electron from the 3d. If 1 electron from 3d is removed, then in 3d there were 7 electrons. If 1 electron from 3d is removed, we are left with the 6 electrons. And I've told you ammonia is towards the stronger side, so in this complex ammonia will pair up the electrons. So the 6 electrons here are paired up, vacant 4s, vacant 4p. See, so this will again give you D2-sp3 hybridization, okay? Now in comparison to this complex, I will come up with another important complex. You can understand that this is diamagnetic as well. I will come to another complex. I'm writing the name here. CO F6 3-. This is the next complex. In comparison to this complex, I'll come up with this complex. Here also, if you find out the oxidation state of cobalt, you will see that cobalt is in +3 oxidation state. So I'm not repeating the cobalt's oxidation state here also. If you are given just to write the bonding of this complex, you have to write the cobalt's configuration also, okay? But here I am not writing this because it is already written. So I'll write cobalt 3 plus in CO F6 3 minus. Look at the position of fluoride. Fluoride is a weak filled ligand. Fluoride is a weak filled ligand, so it will not facilitate the pairing of the electrons of the central metal. Okay, so look at this. It will not facilitate the pairing up. So, see, all the electrons are means the 3D orbital cannot accommodate the ligand electrons now. So, the ligand will have to occupy the higher energy 4D orbitals, and this will give you the hybridization as sp3d2. This is diamagnetic, this is paramagnetic with 4 unpaired electrons, this is inner orbital complex with hybridization d2 sp3, this is outer orbital complex with hybridization sp3 d2. Now the fact is that since I have explained to you what is spectrochemical series, I can tell you that this is a stronger field ligand as compared to fluoride, which is a very weak field ligand. So here pairing does not occur and here pairing occurs. But if you have to explain through valence bond theory, you have to explain this like the magnetic susceptibility results prove that this complex does not have any unpaired ligand, any unpaired electron. So this is a diamagnetic complex as obtained from the magnetic results. So this is having a hybridization d2 sp3, but for this complex the results reveal that there are 4 unpaired electrons, and this is a paramagnetic complex with 4 unpaired electrons. So this is an outer orbital complex with hybridization sp3 d2. Okay, I will show you another example of outer orbital complex with fluoride only. I will take the example of fluoride ligand only and show you another example. Fe F6 4 minus. For iron, iron has 4s2 3d6. And you will, if you find out the oxidation state of iron, it is +2. +2 means the 2 4s electrons will be removed. See, again fluoride is a very weak field ligand, so it will not facilitate spin pairing. This will remain as it is. See, so this is also an outer orbital complex having hybridization sp3 d2 and there are 4 unpaired electrons, hence paramagnetic. Okay? So, this is the case of more or less inner orbital and outer orbital complex. So, I have shown you as much as complexes possible for me. So, this is more or less about the valence bond theory. From the next video, I'll start with the crystal field theory. From the crystal field theory only, you will clearly understand that what is the difference between inner orbital and outer orbital complexes. Okay, so thank you.